Lokpal will not have administrative control over the CBI, and if the CBI continues to be the investigating agency for all complaints made to the Lokpal, and the CBI remains under the administrative control of the government, then there is no point in having a Lokpal, because the whole object of the Lokpal was that it would be an independent agency to investigate cases of corruption. Today the CBI is supposed to report to the CVC, but because the government has the administrative power of transfers, postings, promotions, etc., therefore they are able to influence the CBI investigations. There are many other equally serious issues. The selection committee of the Lokpal, if it is going to be Prime Minister, Leader of Opposition and Chief Justice of India, this is totally unsatisfactory. The Prime Minister and the Leader of Opposition have a common interest to have a weak and pliable Lokpal, because the Leader of Opposition has also been a minister in the past whose cases of corruption can be investigated by the Lokpal. He hopes to become Prime Minister in the future, and therefore he also has the same interest as the Prime Minister in having a weak and pliable Lokpal. A lot of the Chief Justices in the past have been corrupt. That will leave us with no option but to go for a full-fledged people's agitation. This is totally rejected.